We are in Fazioli's factory, located in Sacile. It's a small town close to Venice, northeast from Venice.
Me and also many, all our collaborators, we like a lot of experiments.
For us, we are building our piano. That's all.
专程与大温哥华地区族裔媒体举行圆桌会议的加拿大联邦保守党党领希尔表示，特鲁多上任以来在外交政策上频频出错，重启北美自由贸易协定谈判时向美国总统特朗普屈服，在目前加中关系陷入低谷之际又拒绝与中国国家领导人直接对话，一连串失误却要加拿大普通民众承担后果。
I've been calling on the Prime Minister to pick up the phone and call the President of China to show that initiative to say let's speak about this leader to leader so we can avoid any misunderstandings or misinterpretationsI think that would send a signal that the government is trying to preserve the independence of our system while at the same time showing our willingness to engage at a very high level with the Chinese government.
希尔也回应，加拿大在评估包括华为在内的 5G 技术供应商时，可以在保障国家安全与民众利益间找到平衡。
For now, I believe that the better approach is to look at every aspect of our relationship with the lens of the best possible arrangement for Canada.And partner where we can.
加拿大国会预算办公室周四发布调查报告，指出特鲁多政府去年八月购买跨山输油管扩建项目时，以标价45亿加元成交，高出最低估价9亿加元。希尔警告，一旦特鲁多连任，财政赤字将永无止境，国民也将面临不断加税。
2月25号，在大温哥华华裔聚居的南本拿比选区将会举行联邦补选，其中代表联邦保守党出战的则是华裔申哲熙，代表自由党的则是曾经呢担任了4届省议员、前省议会副议长华裔李灿明，以及空降到这个选区的联邦新民党党领。而这次补选的结果也将会直接影响到今年秋季的联邦大选布局。凤凰卫视组合请吴景苏一恒来自温哥华的报道。